Good morning. I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I hope and I believe that you are all doing fine by the grace of God. As we are going through a difficult time of our generation or this year, we can say, due to corona pandemic, we are all cut off with difficulties of our life. But still God has been so faithful to all of us, to deal with us so kindly and taking care of all of us. Though we have witnessed so many friends of our, they are struggling due to corona and they hospitalized, and some of us also we witnessed that they passed away due to this corona pandemic. We are praying for all of you. And I hope and I believe that you are also praying for others as well as we are praying for each other. This is the way, only way we have left to hold each other in our prayers. So friends, in the midst of this difficult time, God is reminding every time that how we should live in the presence of God in the midst of these difficulties. But our God is in control of everything. So friends, as we gather together through this video this morning, God is with us. So friend, let us all close our eyes and start this morning devotion with a word of prayer. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you and we praise you for your wonderful love, grace and compassion, for your protection, for your grace and mercy, Lord. Though, Lord, we have witnessed so many, Lord, friends who have passed away, and some friends, they had gone through a very difficult time, but we thank God for healing them. And right now also, we are praying for the friends, those who are under the treatment, in hospitals, in houses, Lord. It is you only can heal them. Lord, this is our prayer. Oh Father, let your healing touch be upon them. As we, your people, together come in this manner in our respective homes, houses, Lord, with our family members. Lord, let your presence abide with us. Let your presence move in a very special manner as every individual needs, Lord. You fulfill every individual's heart because you are Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who can meet all our needs. Dear Lord, this time I pray, graciously touch every individual. And Lord, make us holy, make us worthy that our prayers, our thanksgiving of singing, our meditation of your word may be acceptable, and we all will be blessed through your word this morning. You take control of this time. And Lord, you bless us. You lead us. You guide us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. So friends, once again, I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Good morning. And this is our time to sing the praises of our Lord and God. Let us sing this song, giving glory and honor to our Heavenly Father.
wait a little longer, please, Jesus. There's so many still wandering out in sin. Just a little longer, please, Jesus. A few more days to get our loved ones in. Here the labor is so hard, and the workers are so tired, and our weary hearts are yearning for a rest. And we find we're getting anxious to be in that happy home, where we'll receive such peace and happiness. We may look into the skies, and tears will fill our eyes, while our burdened hearts grow heavier each day. First we cry, O Lord, please come, come and take your children home. But then we look around us and we say, wait a little longer, please, Jesus. There's so many still wandering out in sin. Just a little longer, please, Jesus. A few more days to get our loved ones in. The families scattered here and there, but Lord, we love them dear, and maybe we can help them find their way. Then if waiting is the cost, that they may not be lost, Lord, that's the only reason why we say, wait a little longer, please, Jesus. There's so many still wandering out in sin. Just a little longer, please, Jesus. A few more days to get our loved ones in. Just a little longer, please, Jesus. A few more days to get our loved ones in.
The scripture portion for today's meditation is taken from Luke chapter 14, verse 15 to 24. Luke chapter 14 verses 15 to 24. I am reading NRSV, so you can open your Bible and follow your own versions. One of the dinner guests, on hearing this, said to him, "Blessed is anyone who will eat bread in the kingdom of God." Then Jesus said to him, "Someone gave a great dinner and invited many. At the time for the dinner, he sent his slave to say to those who had been invited, 'Come, for everything is ready now.' But they all alike began to make excuses. The first said to him, 'I have brought a piece of land, and I must go out and see it. Please accept my regrets.' Another said, 'I have brought 5 yoke of oxen, and I am going to try them out. Please accept my regrets.' And another said, 'I have just been married, and therefore I cannot come.' So the slave returned and reported this to his master. Then the owner of the house became angry and said to his slave, "Go out at once into the streets and lanes of the town and bring in the poor, the crippled, the blind, and the lame." And the slave said, "Sir, what you ordered has been done, and there is still room." Then the master said to the slave, "Go out into the roads and lanes and compel people to come in, so that my house will be filled. For I tell you, none of those who were invited will taste my dinner." This is the word of God, and may God add his blessing in understanding his holy word. I thank God for this opportunity as I come with the word of God to share with you this morning. And the scripture portion that is read to us, Luke chapter 14, 15 to 24, is an example or parable Jesus is telling on the issue of who is the blessed person to take part in the kingdom of God, or who is the blessed person to eat bread in the kingdom of God. So friends, this passage is a very important passage for all of us, as we are all looking forward to take part in the kingdom of God forever. And in Lord's Prayer, if you do as a part of your practice, morning or evening, I don't know how many times you pray or recite the Lord's Prayer, but one line is there, very important. We do it: "Thy kingdom come." From our childhood, we used to pray that line, and regularly. We love to teach that line or the Lord's Prayer to our children. It is a wonderful prayer the Master of Heaven taught to his disciples. And we are doing that as we consider ourselves the disciple of Jesus Christ. It is very wonderful. So friend, in this small passage, the Master of the Lord of Heaven describes some of the important lessons of heaven, which we as the people of God, believer of Jesus Christ, or the saints of God, we must follow it every day as part of our life, to inherit or to eat the bread in the kingdom of God. Before this passage came into being or to existence, Jesus was attending a dinner party invited by a Pharisees. So many people were invited to that banquet, wedding party. So Jesus also went there. And as Jesus was sitting there. So many dialogues went on, question and answer. And all of a sudden, Jesus taught the people there whom to invite whenever you give a party. Verse 7 to 14, if you'll read, Jesus is teaching, who should be the invitees of our party? In marriage party we give, birthday party, wedding anniversaries, so many parties we used to celebrate. But Jesus is telling, whenever you give any party, dinner party or any other party, whom we should invite so that we may be blessed by the Spirit of God, by the Holy Spirit, by the Heavenly Father. And as he was teaching, at the end of his teaching, he said, verse 14, and you will be blessed because they cannot repay you, for you will be paid at the resurrection of the righteous. Jesus is telling, if you'll do that, if you'll invite or take care of the neglected people, poor and needy and blind and lame, then surely you are going to be blessed. Probably hearing this, one of the dinner guests is telling, sir, blessed, verse 15, blessed is anyone who will eat bread in the kingdom of God. See, take it very seriously, dear people of God, the kingdom of God. So this passage is very important for all of us, because this man is telling, blessed is he who will eat bread in the kingdom of God. And to answering that man's statement, Jesus is narrating a story, giving a story, who will have bread in the kingdom of God. And to tell the man, blessed man in the kingdom of God, Jesus is telling a small story. A man, we all know a man, he wanted to give a party, so he invited his friends. And when the day came for the party, he made everything right, ready for, every meal is ready. And he sent out his slave, servant, go and call my invitees. And the slave went out, door after door he reached and said, sir, the dinner is ready, please come. And as the story says, the first one says, I cannot go. I have bought a piece of land. I must go out and see it. Please accept my regret. Excuses. The second one said, I bought 5 yoke of oxen, so I need to try them, so I cannot come. I hope, please accept my regrets. And the third one says, I'm newly married, I cannot come. Probably the third one also said, please accept my regrets. They all make excuses. And the slave returned back, returned and come. Sir, I called all the invitees, but none of them came because they are already busy doing their own business. And verse 21, then the owner of the house became angry. Dear people of God, please note that the master of or the owner of the house became angry. That means the master of the house, the owner of the house, did not accept their excuses, their pleas. So what master now would do with all dinner is ready, feast is ready, will it go waste? No. Master did not want to go his party wasted or waste. What he said? He sent out his slave to the streets and to the lands of the town and said, bring the poor, crippled and blind and lame. The unexpected, the people who were not invited, now they're coming to the party. Then again, after some time, the slave said, sir, what you ordered has been done, and there is still room. 23 verse says, then the master said to the slave, go out into the roads and lanes, compel people to come, so that my house may be filled. Dear people of God, remember the word compel. Whom? The people, those who were not invited. Compel them to come. Why? I want to see my house filled. And the most fearful, disturbing verse in this passage is 24. For I tell you, none of those who were invited will taste my dinner. Let me read it again, my friends. For I tell you, none of those who were invited will taste my dinner. So today, as we ponder upon this passage, as you are listening, dear people of God, dear saints of God, what went wrong with the invitees? They were the people they're supposed to take part. They were the people they're supposed to enjoy the party. They are the people they're invited. They are the people, their own people of the owner. What went wrong with them? Why the owner rejected them? So first of all, we'll see the invitees are the people of God who have received the invitation of kingdom of God, that is Jesus Christ. That means believers or Christians, the name we use for it. Christians, we are all invitees of God. Don't think It is just a story. No, it is not a story, but it is the reality. If you read Revelation chapter 19, verse 5 to 9, it says, when the Lord will come, a big feast is prepared for the people of God. And you and I, we are all invited for eternal blessing, for eternal joy, for eternal life. How? The day Jesus announced, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. So if you have accepted Jesus Christ, if you believe Jesus Christ, you and I, we are all invited people to eternal joy and eternal blessing. So we are the people called to the great marriage feast of the Lamb, Revelation says. Then what went wrong with the inviters? The second thing is that, dear friends, whenever you see or sit in prayers, remember, God counted you as His own. That is why one day He opened your hearts towards His truth to accept the invitation of eternal God for eternity. The moment you repented, you became the child of God, and God gave you the invitation with His eternal life. So you and I, all believers, we are God's invitees for eternity. The third thing we'll see, how do we reject our invitation? Dear people of God, you may remember your day of baptism. You can recall your day of repentance. It's very good. But have you maintained the day, maintained the life of righteousness? Are you maintaining the life of salvation? Are you maintaining the holy life that you have received from Lord Jesus Christ? We fail to mark in our calendar that He is coming. He is coming. Because if you'll see, the first person, he said, I must go out and see it, the land I purchased. He forgot to mark in his calendar on that day, my friend has called me for a dinner. That is why he failed. The second friend, he failed to mark again the day that my friend has invited me for the dinner. So he went on to the field to taste his oxen. And the third friend, he failed to mark the day of the dinner that his friend invited. So he maintained, he went on to marry and forget to attend his friend's request. How are you neglecting your spiritual life today? Have you lost in this world the passion of this world, with the passion of family, with the passion of being rich? Are you losing your ground? Are you rejecting the word of God? Are you neglecting your prayer life? Are you neglecting your Bible study? Are you neglecting your meditation, spending time with God? Are you rejecting the work of Holy Spirit in your life? Dear friends, remember your friend, the master of the banquet is waiting for you. He is waiting for you. He will come at any moment. He will come at any moment. So as a Christian, as a believer, you and I must ready every day, every moment. Because the day of rejoice, eternity may come. The call may come at any time. Are you ready to your Lord's call? Or are you lost in this world? In your bad business? In your studies? In your pursuit for being rich? Or do you remember, my master has given me an invitation. I must take time to be ready, to prepare, get myself ready, so that whenever and wherever my master says, call will call me, I can attend the party. Blessed are those who will have eat bread or have bread in the kingdom of God. Dear friends, don't neglect, because God is not going to accept any of your excuses or plea. Look what the master says. Verse 21, then the owner of the house became angry. The anointing you have received, the invitation of eternity you have received, be prepared with it. Be ready every time. As I was thinking about our friends, those to whom we have lost due to corona, they never thought in that line. One of my friends, he was also a pastor. His age is only 40. Very unexpectedly, he get sick, and after 7 days, very unexpectedly, he passed away because of corona. He was a pastor. Family was not ready. He was not ready. Nobody was ready to accept. But this is how things happen to us. I don't know when God will call me. But if I'll be ready. Because the party is ready. Jesus said, I will come again. Acts chapter 1. And again, John chapter 14, he says, I'm coming. I'll take you to be with me. You'll be with me where I'll be. So this is the call to every believer. This is the call to every Christian. Be ready, your master is coming. To take for the great feast, eternal joy, eternal peace. Master did not accept any of their excuses. Instead, master became very angry. That means he suggests, he tells, master will punish anybody who is not ready after receiving the invitation. And then says, the fourth thing we can learn from this passage. Many times we say, I am baptized, I am very much secure. No, friends, it is not right. Only the one who can secure, who walk with God, who love God, and who obeys Him through, obeys His word. That man and woman of God can say, I'm ready, I'm secured. If you are rejecting the power of God, the work of Holy Spirit, you are not secure. You are not obeying. If you are not obeying the word of God, you are not living on the word of God, you are not secure. So friends, be careful. Your master, your father is coming. Son, be ready. Daughter, be ready. My people, be ready. A great day awaits for you. Are you ready? One day I will call you for the dinner. Are you going to take part with me? Are you ready? Dear people of God, the master was very angry. If you and I will reject our invitation by disobeying God's word, by living worldly or loving the lust of this world, remember, somebody else will take our place. How it happened? Let's see. The master says, go out into the street, to the lanes, call the poor, crippled, and blind, and lame, that my house shall be filled. If you reject God's invitation for eternity, your place someone will take. You'll be the loser, my friends. This is the day we need to look at, examine ourselves, where we are lacking in our relationship with God, where we are lacking in our spiritual life. Today is the day, as God speaks, repent and come. Because God is waiting for you. God is waiting for you. Each day you are given a chance, it's a chance of meeting your Father who is waiting for you. And finally, the most fearful thing this passage says, I tell you, none of those who were invited will taste my dinner. As I was going through this passage, I was very much afraid. And I pray, Lord, have mercy on me. Forgive me my negligences. Help me to be ready for your call. Why? The master of this banquet says, compel the people to come. But the master is not visiting or sending his slave for the second time to the invitees. What it tells us, you and I, the called out people of God, if we reject the call of our Father, invitation of our Lord Jesus Christ, we will be sent out from His presence. Many times we want to exchange our life, but don't try to do that, friends. What happens when we repent, upon our sins, and come to Christ? He gives you and me the robe of salvation, the robe of righteousness, the robe of holiness. We become His child. Are you living, walking with your Father? Are you living in the presence of your Father? Because He is the one going to give a big feast, a dinner for all His people. But are you ready? Are you ready? One verse I'll read and we'll finish. Matthew chapter 24 and 42 says, therefore you also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an unexpected time. Dear people of God, we must ready every day, because we don't know which is the last day for me or for us. Which hour is the last for me or for us to meet our Heavenly Father. So that we can take place in His big banquet or dinner with all saints of the earth, purchased by the blood of Jesus Christ. Therefore, if you and I neglect our invitation, we just cannot say forgive or forget. I expect I am forgiven. No. No excuses the Master will consider, because He considers you and me as His own and invited and opened our hearts to His truth, so that we can accept His truth and live on His truth in this world. So, if we'll do that, if we'll neglect or reject, we just cannot escape the punishment waiting for ungodly people. Therefore, dear people of God, dear people of Lord Jesus Christ our Lord, as you are listening, examine yourself. Is your relationship with your Father is right? Are you walking in the righteousness or the truth God has set for you and me? Are you obeying His word, living out His word? Or are you neglecting His call, His invitation? May God bless and give us grace to all of us, that we may be able to see our true spiritual relationship every day with our Father, and live a life of preparedness to meet our Lord anytime He calls, that we may attain the beautiful, joyous moment in eternity with Him. May God bless all of us. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you, Lord. Out of innumerable people living around this world, you choose us to invite to your eternity, eternal blessing, by opening our hearts to accept you as Lord and God, and confessing our sin to come before your throne of grace. Lord, we have done that. But as we live on this sinful world, Many times we neglect the life you have given, the salvation you have given, the holiness you have given to us. Forgive, O Lord, and accept. Make us holy and worthy, and help us to live a life acceptable in thy holy sight. Bless all your people listening, and set their hearts right with you, that none of us will fail to attend the big day when you will come. Let your name be glorified. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Let us receive the benediction. May the love of God the Father, the grace of Lord Jesus Christ the Son, and the sweet fellowship, communion, and the presence of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with all of us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Namaskar. May God bless you all and have a wonderful time.